Hello everyone. As a beginner, you guys might find difficult using OpenAI API for various tasks. As discussed, money and not everyone can afford it. It limits your learning. So in this video, I will be telling you how to do information retrieval type of the tasks without using OpenAI model and its embedding. We'll be using LangChain and Huggingface only to build our information retrieval system. As all are open source, you can use as much as you want. So you can learn much more than using an OpenAI. After that, you can integrate it using OpenAI key in your system and build much more complex model. But as of now, you can just use it to learn much more things and keep learning. To create an information retrieval system, we need two things. One is embedding and other is model. So alternative to OpenAI embedding, we could use different. Here, LangChain provide various type of the embedding, among which there are fake embedding, sentence transformer embedding, and along with OpenAI embedding. OpenAI charges money, so we'll use this alternative. Similar to OpenAI model, there is its alternative we can use. Some of them are Llama, Google Flan T5. In this video, we'll be using Flan T5 from the Google. You can just find the Flan T5 and experiment with its various best models from an Huggingface. So let's get started. The first step of every machine learning project is installing the dependencies. Here we need to install 4 dependencies such as Beautiful Soup, LangChain, Huggingface Hub, Sentence Transformer, and Phi CPU. So we need Beautiful Soup to scrape the URL from a Wikipedia page, LangChain because of its modular functions, and Huggingface Hub to access its model, Sentence Transformer for embedding, and Phi CPU for semantic search. So the next step, we'll just import all our necessary module that we have already installed in just few minutes ago. So for extracting the URL, we use, as always, Cristiano Ronaldo Wikipedia, because Ronaldo is better than Messi. Now to extract the content from the URL, we'll need Beautiful Soup. We'll define a function called extract text, where we'll pass URL and we'll write response equals to request.get URL. It will fetch the content from the URL. We'll pass response to the Beautiful Soup. Here we'll use html.parse, as URL might contain various tags such as script tags, maze tag, and many more. So in this video, I will remove script tag for processing of the URL. You can also remove other tag for better results. So to remove the script tag, we can just loop over the soup object and extract it. Then we'll return content from our response. To do that, we just need soup object get text, and we'll convert every string to the load. Now all the text can be extracted from the extract text function. We will now create a text file for storing the text content extracted just now. To store the text content, we can open a file named ronaldo.txt and as f and write all the content to it. So next step, we'll load the ronaldo.txt file to our LangChain. To do that, we can just define the loader, which will be an object for an text loader which takes an file .txt. Now we will load the object using document equals to loader.load. So in real life, the text file might be big. So we will split the text file into multiple chunks so that it can be easily accessed and loaded in our model. To do that, we will create an text splitter object which inherited from recursive character text splitter, which we have already imported few minutes ago. The chunk size for now will be of 1000 characters, and chunk overlap will be 0. We will define the separator such as space, comma, and next line. So we create a struct variable which stores all the splitter context from text splitter object. We will pass document in it. The docs variable contains all the information of our document, which is split in a chunk. So to view the docs, we can see by, so the page content is the document text which is split in 1000 characters, and metadata contains information about the file. The value such as the next line can be removed using preprocessing, which will result in much better result. For now, we will not remove the next line character, but it will be better if you do so. So next step will be to define an embedding. We'll be using Huggingface embedding for it. Huggingface by default uses sentence piece embedding. So to do that, we will just define a variable embedding equals to Huggingface embeddings. Huggingface embedding we have already ported few minutes ago. We will create an database variable for our files. The files is by the Google for semantic source, and we'll pass our splitted documents and embeddings. It might take few seconds to download all the necessary imports and define our database variable from files. So next step will be defining our model. So to define our model, we'll be using Huggingface app. You can download a model and use it for inference, but we'll be using Huggingface app as it provides API for it. To do that, model will define a variable called LDM, and we will Huggingface. The first argument in Huggingface app will be repo ID. The repo ID for flan T5 is Google flan T5 small. Other argument in Huggingface app will be model argument. As it is large language model, it will have temperature to control an output and max length. So for here we'll use max length of 256. Next we will create an thin object to load our LLM. Now we are in final step. So we require a query such as when was Ronaldo born. Now a DB instance created just a few minutes ago will be used for semantic search of an query in the chunk of the document we have created earlier. We will then pass the document in our model, where question will be an query. So you can see the required result from an model.